Great to see all of you in this session. Very fruit, I mean, very energetic. So I can see 4,086. Okay, 486. Sorry, 486 participants, and I can see the variety of the participants. So I have to switch my plant from my earliest plant, digital marketing. Okay, only focused on digital marketing on product. So I have to focus on personal branding itself, you know, because I can see the variety of participants. I can see the student, even some of my ex-students or those who are graduated, now working cliques, okay? They are also, I mean, messaging me. So that's why I have to shift my contents, which can suit to everyone. Yes, Mr. Raju. Anything you want to say? Okay, good. Okay, great to see. Digital marketing, okay? So I think I need to introduce myself. Most of you know me very well, and also has been introduced by Dr. Azrin, my good friend, and my one of the research counterpart. So welcome to the session, digital marketing session. And digital marketing is not going to end within 1 and 15 minutes. It's an evolution. You can see, you know, when you talk about digital marketing, 1995, when internet was introduced commercially, it was only talk about, you know, just a website. There is no any transaction. After that, 2000 is the era of Amazon. Amazon is the pioneer. Okay, in terms of digital marketing, at that time, digital marketing is not like this. It's only the web base. Okay, so then after 2010 is really a push for the digital marketing. So you can see tremendous changes in 2010 after the social media took over the internet. Now the dominating platform is a social media platform. So.
Sean, this is Leonard, and I have started following your channel recently. Support your insights and ideas and advises into investment in properties in Malaysia.
I think there is an interruption.
That investing in the
maybe host can mute the person who reject my question.
Like this 5 doors.
Okay, thank you. So that's right. So evolution happened every, you know, every 5 years, every 10 years. Evolution means the tremendous evolution, I mean the drastic changes. But if you look at the digital marketing, every day change and change and change. 5 years back, people are talking about, you know, digital marketing in the context of social media. Now, more than that, nowadays the latest trend is a video-based marketing. Okay, TikTok. TikTok was, you know, used by most of the youngsters to, how to say, to promote themselves. After that, TikTok has been move to another level of marketing by introducing some functions. For instance, you can use TikTok to promote your organization, yourself, and also your product and your, you know, your service as well. So that's why today is going to be a session which I can cover product branding, or we call it product digital marketing, service digital marketing. And another one, since we have a lot of lecturers, and also there are so many working cliques, they're not doing business, but they can convert themselves into their product. How you can convert yourself into a product or brand, that is called as a personal branding. Okay, you can convert, you are your product. There is no any physical or any digital product that you are going to sell in digital world. So what I'm going to do is you just do some personal branding. So that is also called as digital marketing. Okay, before I proceed, can I do some rapid fire question? Rapid fire means I will ask few questions. You just put in chat box. I just want to see how familiar you are in terms of digital marketing, because we have some myth. Digital marketing means it's only for the people who have a technical knowledge. Especially who can do programming, who can, you know, design the poster, who can talk very well, who can edit video. That is actually myth. You don't require to learn everything under the sun to be a digital marketer. You just need effort, passion, and go according to the evolution of the digital marketing. When you move with digital marketing, whatever happened today, now, at this second, you know, now, okay, you can be a digital marketer. And you are not required to sell any product. Sometimes you can do like a personal branding itself. Okay, it also can create a commercial value to yourself. For instance, our students, our lecturers. Okay, so I will touch about that one. So it's going to be 1 hour 15 minutes. Anything you want to ask? You can ask any question. You can interject, no problem. Okay. If you do feel I'm moving very fast, you can say, "Hello, sir, can you go slow a bit? Then I can reduce my tempo or reduce my, you know, volume of the movement." Okay, no problem. Okay, let me ask you very few questions. I give you option to do a personal branding or digital marketing for yourself. Facebook and Instagram. Which one you choose? Only one, yeah? Facebook or Instagram? In your chat box, I want to see. Facebook, IG, Facebook, IG, Facebook, IG, Facebook, Instagram, IG, Facebook, IG, Insta, YouTube. Right? Only your two options. Okay. Rapid fire question, huh? Please. Before I start a session, I still, you know, I feel a bit itchy to ask some question. Okay, Facebook, IG, Insta. Okay, IG, both. I don't want any diplomatic answer. I need an IG or Facebook. Some of you giving a diplomatic answer. Facebook, IG, oh my God. Okay, enough. I have to switch another question. Okay. If I give you LinkedIn and Facebook, which is your preference? LinkedIn and Facebook. LinkedIn. Facebook and LinkedIn. Okay, LinkedIn. Oh, dominated by Facebook. Facebook, Facebook, LinkedIn. Facebook. LinkedIn, Facebook. Facebook. Oh, okay. Facebook still dominating. Okay, LinkedIn is not very famous. Okay, but actually LinkedIn very important. Okay, LinkedIn is very important. I will touch about LinkedIn when I talk about personal branding of yourself. Okay, so digital marketing don't only focus on, you know, product or service. It can go beyond that, sir. You know, beyond all of this. Okay. Let me ask you one another question. If I give you the option, travel or Netflix, which one you choose? Travel or Netflix? Don't answer travel because of the COVID. Because you're so pissed off with the, you know, COVID. Travel, Netflix. Travel, Netflix. Travel, travel, Netflix. Netflix, travel, 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 wow, okay, Netflix, Netflix, travel, okay, okay, great. This can give some preliminary understanding about the participant, okay, so there is no there is no any dominating, fully dominating answer. So some people prefer to travel. Some people prefer to Netflix. So those who are traveling, they are extroverts. Netflix means they just watch movie, just sit, relax, go to the introverts people. They like to travel, but not you know, very often. Okay, that's the thing. Okay, good. Another one. The last rapid fire question. Okay. This answer can be different, you know, depend on the age group. Okay, maybe lecturers also can respond to this one. Okay. If I give you the two options, two type of reading. Okay. Two type of reading. Eh? I give you the option. You read the book or you want to watch YouTube to learn. Which one? YouTube or book? To learn something. Book, YouTube. You see? YouTube. Okay? OIT also, book, YouTube. Okay, book, YouTube. Okay, good. Okay, I can see, you know, most of you are digital marketing oriented people. Okay, because you like to watch YouTube. YouTube, when you watch YouTube, it's mean you like to read something. When you listen something, excuse me. When you listen to something, it's actually a part of reading. Okay, so most of you like to watch YouTube instead of open a book and find out the special station for you to read a book. YouTube, you can watch anywhere, in the train, in the aeroplane, wherever you want, you can watch. Okay, good, fine. Okay, I can get some, you know, understanding about the digital marketing from point of the audience. Okay, good. Let me share, okay, a simple slide which I have prepared, okay, but this session is not going to be purely based on the slides, okay, so I will going to share with you, not in terms of practical things, because it's 1 hour, 15 minutes, I have given very, very, you know, precise time, 1 hour, 15 minutes, so I have to tell, I have to give an exposure, okay, an exposure to all of you regarding what is digital marketing. What are the digital marketing opportunities available for you? What you have not seen until today, so I can expose to you. Then, sometimes you have seen, but you have not explored, or you have not enjoyed the benefit of that particular digital marketing tool. There are so many tools that you could enjoy. Not only to the commercial, you know, for commercial purpose. Sometimes, you know, you do digital marketing, not for commercial, which means not to earn money. Sometimes it's only for to get some reputation, some fame, popularity. That's it. Okay. But some people use digital marketing, and not some, most of the people use digital marketing to convert their audience. Okay, convert the audience, those who are watching their YouTube or their contents as their buyer. They convert the audience to the buyer. So there are few types of the digital marketing. Okay, so that's why, you know, you have to set the objective. Okay, let's say you start a YouTube. Okay, start a YouTube. Definitely your objective is to earn money. Okay, through your video. But not all people. Some, no. Some open their YouTube just to spread the information, knowledge, whatever data that they are, you know, they have. They just want to share. That's it. Okay. Right. Okay. Right now we go to digital marketing, which is a slide. Okay. As usual, it's not this slide. It's not you know, slide like a classroom slide. This slide is just a informational, you know, a piece of paper. That's it. Okay. Can you see the slide? Okay. Good. Okay. How famous you are in the Google? How famous you are in the Google? Now, what you do? You go to your, you know, Google Chrome, or Mozilla, or Safari, whatever browser that you are using, go and type your full name. You see, what are the things pop up when you type in Google? Just go like this. Okay? This is the first digital marketing rule. When you are not famous, or you are not pop-up, or you are not captured by Google, something wrong. Okay? Because by the time, your name should be in the Facebook, okay, in the LinkedIn, in the, you know, any other platforms. Just type and see. Just type. Okay, go to platform like this. Just type your full name. Okay, my name, before I type, it's come up. It means I'm in the radar of the Google search. That is the first rule. And also for your product as well. Okay? That part I will move later. Okay. This is just a first understanding or basic understanding or fundamental. Okay. Just type and see. What are the things come up? Okay. This is personal branding. I more focus on personal branding and also the product branding. Okay. You see. So is there anything some, you know, like this? When you search your name? Okay. You see. Today, 10 people search about me. Okay. And this is my personal branding pages. So, of course, I'm a lecturer. So, I do have a knowledge panel. This thing is a personal branding. Okay. And when you scroll, okay, this is only visible to me, not to you. But I can see, oh, today I'm not very famous. Eh? Okay. So, when you search my name, so my this data will increase. So how data are working together are interconnected in this world right now. Okay. This is the first. Okay? Those who have no idea about digital marketing, you start with your name. Start with your name. Make yourself popular. Okay. You see, everything about yourself. Okay. LinkedIn. This is so-called personal branding, LinkedIn. I learned LinkedIn from the one of the international trainer. Okay. LinkedIn, I learned, okay, from one of the international trainer, of course, the paid one. Okay. LinkedIn is very important, not only for the those who are working. As a student, you need a LinkedIn in order to make yourself popular and connected to the professional. Facebook, everyone can be connected. But LinkedIn, not like that. LinkedIn, 95% are professionals. And you can look for the job, you can look for the business opportunities, and you can look for the network, and you can build your network in your LinkedIn. That is called personal branding. Okay? So when you click, you can see, you know? So that is digital marketing for yourself. Okay? This is the thing. So everything come up. Okay. So, start with your name. Okay, that is my recommendation. Okay, start with your name. Then start with your product. Start with your service, whatever is it. Okay. Okay, so this is about me. Okay. So, you can search about me in my website as well. Okay. Okay, first quote. When you do digital marketing, you have to remember all of this quote. Okay. First, Michael Porter. I think most of you are management student. Regardless of management or non-management student, you should know about Michael Porter. He said that, you know, 2001, you know, that is the era of Amazon.com. This guy can forecast what is going to be happen another 20 years. Okay, Michael Porter. He said, the key question is not whether to deploy the internet technology. Internet technology was officially introduced 1995. So just 6 years, he can say. The key question is not whether to deploy the internet technology. Companies have no choice if they want to stay competitive, but how to deploy it. That's the thing. Look at UEM. Maybe when UA was started, 1986 or 1984, I think, something like that, okay, 80s. There is no website. But by the time the latest technology come up, UA need to invest themselves and need to, you know, come up with the website, systems, and so on. Okay, you see, 2001, 20 years back. I think another 20 years is going to be full of AI, you know, augmented reality, artificial intelligence, and so on. Okay, even now also full. Okay. Okay, digital marketing. Ignoring online marketing is like opening a business, but not telling anyone. So when you run a business, even you run a nasi lemak business, just a roadside or in front of the UUM gate, if you ignore online marketing, okay, it's like opening a business but not telling anyone, something like that. Okay, that's why, you know, you can see nowadays even nasi lemak sellers, even your father or mother, yes, nasi lemak is just a nasi lemak. I'm not talking about McD nasi lemak or KFC nasi lemak. Okay, McD KFC nasi lemak is a different one. And I eat, I don't feel the nasi lemak. Okay, I'm talking about the roadside nasi lemak. They also, some of my, I have one friend, you know, I like to buy nasi lemak from, you know, one of the shop. This guy, you know, just a small shop, but he moved to online marketing. Very simple. I was wondering, you know, hello bro, you are very good, yeah? You can adopt the online marketing. I mean, Malay lah, I call it. How will it be, you know, internet business, yeah? Then he replied just one sentence. Ala bro, nowadays very simple. He used only Foodpanda. When I got to the shop, eh, Foodpanda, you know, just waiting, you know. Few people are waiting. Okay, Foodpanda. Foodpanda is online marketing. Cloud Kitchen. Or in Malay, we call it, the name is very funny. Yeah? I think Dapur Awan, eh? Something like that. If you directly translate. Okay, if you look at my Facebook, I teach this word. It's not actually Dapur Awan. There is another word, actually. Okay, this is the thing. So you cannot ignore. So not only for your business, as a student, now you are in the, you know, you are going to be in the job market, maybe after 1 year, 2 years, or now you are doing practical, or now you are working. You have to go for your online marketing. Market yourself in online. How you want to market? Don't market yourself in YouTube. Nobody watch you about yourself. Don't tell, oh, my name is Madhi, I'm, you know, this one, that one, eh? Sorry, yeah. Okay, even Netflix won't accept my movie, okay? So what you do is, you have to do personal branding, okay? Which is LinkedIn. LinkedIn is one of the good ones, not Facebook. Facebook for everyone. LinkedIn for the professional network. So I encourage the students, if let's say you don't have a product, you move to LinkedIn as your digital marketing yourself. Okay, this is my personal view about LinkedIn. Okay, I'm not a promoter for the LinkedIn. I'm not an ambassador. Okay, I'm not an ambassador. Based on my experience, I got a lot of opportunity from the LinkedIn. If you look at my LinkedIn, okay, I have updated everything over there. Okay, so many people are connected. Okay, it's very important. But if you ignore, it means you are not telling anyone about yourself. How to tell? Use internet, digital marketing. Okay. Okay, this one. General Electric, GE, US. Beth Comstock, Vice Chair of General Electric. Okay, I think most of you know who's, you know what is General Electric, yeah? This is the basic marketing. Okay, talk about digital marketing and basic marketing. You can't sell anything if you can't tell anything. Okay. If you do not know how to tell about yourself, how you want to sell your product? You, if let's say you do not know how to tell about yourself, no problem. At least you know, tell about your product. That's why you can't sell anything if you can't tell anything. Okay, let me tell you a tip, sir, in digital marketing. Those who are very, very successful in digital marketing or market their product through online are good storytellers. When you are good storyteller, it means story that can convince the customer, not story that confuse your customer. There are only two methods, whether you convince your customer or you confuse your customer. When you convince, they become your buyer. When you confuse, they run away from you. only two C. When you convince, the another C will come, cash. Okay? When you get cash, you will get another C, comfortable. Okay? So we want C, okay, not A. I don't like A, only C. Okay, so that's the thing. So when I talk about digital marketing, you have to think about this one. You have to convince. So how to convince? You have to be storyteller. Okay, I just want to quote from the, you know, Steve Jobs. Steve Jobs always mentioned this one. He's one of the good storyteller. When you listen to his speech, he's not a digital marketer, but he knows how to convince people by giving a very, very promising stories. Very promising stories. When you listen, you will like, oh my God, this is a very wonderful product. I need to buy. And when you buy, you're not going to regret to buy this one or their product. Okay, storytelling. So that's why, you know, you have to tell. How to tell? You cannot tell to your friend. Because if you want to tell every one of your friends, it's very difficult. How to tell? You have to tell in a bulk way. Okay, that is digital marketing. And you have to choose the right platform. In Malaysia, okay, the right platform, okay, is mostly Instagram, TikTok, YouTube, Facebook, and few other things. Let's say, sir, I don't have any idea about write anything. I don't want to write anything because very confusing to convince my customers through Facebook or Instagram. Forget about that. What do you do? There's another way. Okay, I will touch about this one in the end of the session. Okay, stay tuned. We want to know the another secret. You don't need to sell any product. You don't need to tell about yourself. You don't need to tell about your service. You still can get money. Okay, because I will tell about this one. This is one of the initiatives from the government. Okay, you still can get some amount. And you guys, students, you have a lot of time, pleasure time, you have a wonderful time without any commitment. Okay, you have no commitment, you know, you're not going to, you know, repair your car, you know, bring your wife or bring your husband everywhere. Okay, you have full focus on certain things. So I think your age, okay, especially students, your age, 20 to 29, it's a wonderful age. This is your lifetime investment period. You have to invest yourself in a lot of things. Sometimes you feel very tired. Don't worry. You still need, you have energy. But don't put this effort, at the, you know, effort that you're supposed to put at the age of 20, in the age of 55. Then it will lead to a lot of problems. That's why, you know, if you want to do something, do right now. Do today. Do at this moment. Okay? Whatever is it. Okay. When you talk about, digital marketing, okay, definitely digital marketing because of Industry Revolution 4.0, and we are Society 5.0. What is so-called Society 5.0? Society with a lot of technological gadgets. If you walk, your friend asks you one question. Hello, bro. Can I get your number? What is your WhatsApp number? Then you reply, actually, I don't have WhatsApp. Your friend will laugh at you. You will be a laughing stock in the gang. Okay? Like myself. When I was a student, 2003, I was a laughing stock of my friend because I don't have info. Almost 2 months when I joined university. Okay? At that moment, 2004, I think. 3-4. Okay? So nowadays, when you say there is no WhatsApp, people will, look at you in, one kind, So digital marketing because of Industrial Revolution 4.0. What is that? Okay. What is that? Fusion of digital revolution, technologies and the interaction across the physical, digital, biological domains. You see? Physical, digital, biological domains. All of these are connected. Now you see your iPhone. Okay. What is biological domains? How come you can connect to the biological thing? Very simple. Look at your smartwatch. Okay. When you wear your smartwatch, wristband or smartwatch, whatever is it, it will tell how long you walk and how many hours you walk. That is actually biological. And it will tell about your heart rate. It will tell about your, you know, your pressure, oxygen level. And through, let's say, suddenly your oxygen level is very low. Or at this moment, people are worried, you know. Oh my God, why my oxygen level? Am I infected by COVID-19? You will rush to BP lab to check. Am I right? Because of your smartwatch. That's the thing. That is so-called industrial revolution in terms of biological things. It can link up to your body. And now we have a lot of additional or advanced function not available in Malaysia. If let's say it can tell about your body condition, okay, and it will connect to the doctors. And doctor knows that your health is not promising, and doctor will call you. Are you okay? If let's say three times they are calling you, you're not okay, they will locate your location. Oh, in front of UVM gate, you just fell down. In front of, they will send the ambulance until that extent, but not available in Malaysia. Okay, they are trying this one. So you see, that is digital marketing. Doctors also need a digital marketing. They are earning, but still need a digital marketing, because in the long run, digital marketing, it will move to everyone. Okay? Okay. You see? So, just want to give you the preview about digital marketing. Okay? You should know what is digital marketing. Because we have a digital marketing mean, or you must have a high-end computer. You should have a high-speed internet connection. Of course, high-speed internet connection. You should, with a lot of technical knowledge. Remember, digital marketing is not only for the people who learn the digital. It's for everyone. Okay? sorry. Wait. Let me stop for a while and come back again. Okay. Okay. Digital marketing. So, let me diagnose a little bit technical fault. Okay. Okay. Okay, this one. You see, digital marketing, okay, encompasses all marketing effort that use an electronic device or the internet. So let me tell you the secret. Whatever is it, okay, you are very good in computer skill, you still need to learn basic marketing. I mean, learn mean at least you exposed to the marketing concepts. Okay, I have asked, you know, oh, you want to do digital marketing, do you know what is the marketing? Oh, marketing is just tell to any you know, someone about something. No. Okay, that is just a basic. You don't need to be very advanced, but at least you know what is marketing. Very important thing. Okay, that's why, you know, we have a wonderful program. Okay, marketing program. Also, we have a lot of, you know, marketing subjects. Okay, so you can get exposure.
I just need 10 minutes.
Nur Aiza, are you communicating with me? Nur Aiza, are you communicating?
Wow, the magic, eh?
So, Catherine, can you unmute the person? Okay, thank you. these are the do and don'ts in the online classes. Okay. Okay, great. Okay. So, digital marketing encompasses all the marketing effort. So, you put a lot of marketing effort in the electronic format. Okay, device or the internet. Nowadays, you know, once upon a time, there is only one electronic device to access the internet, which is computer. Now, we have wonderful devices. You can access internet just using your laptop, your desktop computer, your tablet, your smartphone, even your smartwatch can answer the call. When people answer the call by using a smartwatch, when I look at them, I laugh, you know, because it looks like Power Rangers. When I was 12 years old, Power Rangers is a very famous cartoon. They will talk, call the robots, you know, something like that. At that time, it's a laughing stock. Now it's a reality. Now it's a reality. Okay, you see, sometimes, you know, laughing stock become, you know, breakthrough innovation. Okay, people are talking through, you know, watch. The answer, but yeah, I receive a call, I receive a call, but I don't use that one because I feel it is quite laughing stock for me until now. Okay, anyway, so it's up to you whether you want to adopt the technology or not. Okay, that is digital marketing. Yeah, so when you use any device or internet, so you need only two: device and internet. The third one is your effort with your knowledge about digital marketing. You can learn digital marketing anywhere, from YouTube, from internet. Now his world is open, you know, it's open world. Okay. And what is digital marketing? Business leverage digital channels. Okay. You need to choose digital channel. In the marketing, channel is very, very important. Channel will ensure your reachability, how you can reach your customer. When you fail to reach your customer, it means you fail to deliver your product as it is. Okay? That's why you need a digital channel. Okay? Which is search engines. Search engine is a wonderful thing. Search engines like Google.com, okay, Bing.com, Baidu. If you go to China, forget about Google. You have to go to Bing.com. Okay? Don't think, oh, I don't want to do Facebook marketing in China. Facebook marketing in China, it's not applicable. Okay? Because China using Baidu.com and some other platforms. Okay. Social media. Social media is very, very famous after 2008. Okay? It's a boom of the social media. Okay? Social media, including Facebook, Twitter, you know, whatever media that you can socialize. YouTube also actually social media. When you can share, when you can like, when you can comment, it's social media. That is a basic understanding or basic definition. Okay, don't say social media is only Facebook. Yeah? Even YouTube also social media, but it's more to the video content. But when you go to the Facebook, it's more to a multi-platform, which means you can upload video, you can upload images, text, and so on. Twitter, and also you can use social media applications such as, you know, WhatsApp. Okay, WhatsApp definitely you cannot like, but you can share, you can comment in the group. Okay, WhatsApp, and WhatsApp also we have two different WhatsApp. When you want to run a business, don't use WhatsApp personal. Use WhatsApp business, because you can get a lot of insights. Insights mean data, okay? And also email marketing. Email marketing is not so popular, but still applicable. Email marketing, because email is one of the common medium for everyone. Okay? Common medium for everyone. And nowadays, you know, email become a last choice. For example, you call EUM, and nobody pick up the call, for example, because of the COVID-19. What you will do? Are you going to WhatsApp? No. Definitely, you will look for the email address, UUMIT. Then you will send email. Therefore, email still a valid communication to communicate with your customer. Remember, do not ignore the email. email marketing. And another one is a website. Website also to connect with the current, you know, customer. And you can provide a lot of information in the website. Okay? Website is a single platform, can provide everything. Okay? That's digital marketing. Okay, look at this one. Okay? Let me ask you another rapid fire question. Okay? Just take a quick, you know, answering session. Rapid fire question. Okay? Are you ready? Rapid fire question. Only two options. Huh? No diplomatic answer. Okay? No diplomatic answer. Okay. When you want to search something, you choose Google or Bing.com. Which one? Google or Bing? Google, huh? All Google. Oh, you don't know what is Bing? B-I-N-G. Bing. Okay. Don't know. Oh my God. Okay. Google. Oh, I know. I'm very sure. I'm pretty sure Google, it's really make money because of you. Because Google. Okay. All Google. Okay. I have another rapid fire question. Okay. Rapid fire question. Okay. Platform, same Internet Explorer. Okay. This one, just say yes or no. Just say yes or no. Okay. Do you use your Internet Explorer or your Edge to download Google Chrome? Just use Internet Explorer to download Google Chrome. Yes or no? It means yes, no, yes, no, yes, no, yes, no. Okay, yes. Okay. Okay. Most of you, I know, when you install the software, format your computer, you open your Internet Explorer, or you use your Microsoft Edge, which is your browser, to download Google Chrome. After that, you use Google Chrome. Then you forget about everything. Microsoft Edge, Internet Explorer, everything you forget. I'm very sure. Because Google is a king. King in the internet world right now. You can't ignore the Google in your digital marketing. Okay? Because everything deployed by the Facebook. Facebook, you know, WhatsApp. WhatsApp is under Facebook. Instagram, Facebook also. YouTube is Google. Okay. Everything. So that's why, you know, you can't ignore the Google. Okay, great. Now we move to another one. Huh? I just want to share the importance and some other important platforms. Okay. You close your eye, you open your eye, you sleep, or you whatever you are doing, okay, or you know, swimming, whatever you are doing, this is definitely happening in the world. You see, what happens in an internet a minute? You see, I think this data is a last year data, okay, or no, 5 years data. I just took the 5 years data. Today I have the latest data, but I did not include. Okay, I just want you imagine what happened right now after 6 years. Okay, I think this is an old data. Okay, let us see what happened in an internet a minute. Okay, okay, from the most dominating pages until the last dominating. Okay, you look at this one, YouTube. Even, you know, before the session, I upload one YouTube in my YouTube channel. Okay? Even I upload one YouTube video in my YouTube channel. Okay, you see. So, by looking at this one, you can visualize what you could do in the internet world, digital marketing. Okay? It's all data. That's why, you know, you don't see IG, TikTok, and so on. Okay? Now you see. YouTube. When you feel bored, okay, you get bored, what you will do? Definitely you will open a YouTube. Okay, you open your YouTube and look for something, at least listen to song or watch something. Okay, and sometimes what you will do, you will go to Google. You see, a minute, 2 million search queries in Google. Okay, you want to see power of Google? Very simple. I will show to you one simple example. Okay, Facebook, Twitter. Twitter is not very famous in Malaysia. Twitter is very famous among the professionals. I'm using Twitter as well. Okay, I use all. Okay, most of the things I use. YouTube, Google, Facebook, Twitter, Flickr, LinkedIn, Pandora, I have account, Amazon, I have account, just for the classroom purpose. Okay, and so on. Blogger, I used 10 years ago, but now Blogger is not very famous, Blogspot. Okay, even I stopped training the people about the Blogspot because it's not very famous. Okay. Okay, wonderful. You see. Okay, this is the power of digital marketing. You can turn your small business, like I told to you before this, nasi lemak business. Just a nasi lemak business. You look at this guy just wearing the black t-shirt with the one tagline. Okay, black, not t-shirt, I think the round neck t-shirt. Okay, round neck. And this guy can transform his business to sales power-ups by using digital marketing. Okay, because you are telling, hello, are you asking question, Nazira? Nazira? Okay, sorry. I have to respect my audience. The moment you open your mic, I'm waiting for your question. Okay, so I thought you are asking question. Okay, great. Okay, turn your small business into a sales power-ups. How? Just using a digital marketing tools. Which tool you want to use? It depends on the your business. If let's say you are selling a nasi lemak, you cannot use you cannot use Shopee unless you have a frozen nasi lemak. But now, even in Shopee or Lazada, you still can sell nasi lemak. Okay, you can sell nasi lemak in, but you quote in your Shopee only delivered to these places only Klang area, only Alaska area, something like that. You have to put, but you cannot go beyond that your region. Okay, beyond your region. But when you use Foodpanda, GrabFood, or Mau Tapao, what else? Is there any other platform? Foodpanda, GrabFood, what else? Anything? I need your point, audience. Any point? GrabFood, Damakan. Oh, another one. Bukus Eat. Ah, yeah, Bukus Eat. Okay, what else? But most famous is Foodpanda, Mau Tapao, and few other things. Yeah? GrabFood. Okay, Bukus Eat, Halo. Okay, there is another one. Eh? Queen. A Queen is a payment system. Quick Send, GrabFood. Okay, oh yeah, good. Tapau Food. Okay, good. Mau Tapau ka? Ataupun Tapau Food. Deliver Eat. Oh, good, great. You see, I think you guys, no need to be trained. You have a lot of knowledge. Anyway, you can use when you are selling an asylum. Let's say you are selling cake from your house. Home cake, homemade cake. So you can use certain tools. So even though, okay, you know, I always use this code. Even though you are well educated, you are PhD holder, whatever is it, but you do not know which tool you're supposed to use, you fail to perform. You should know right tool with the right effort. With the wrong tool, with the right effort, you will fail to perform, lead to failure. So I always pinpoint this issue, this point. Right tool with the right effort. Very important. Okay? Okay. You see, these are some wrong assumptions. Okay. Please remove this type of wrong assumption about digital marketing. This could be a barrier to you. Okay? You have a great product. You are so proud that you have a great product. But remember that even the most brilliant marketer can't sell a poor product or service over the long run. It means you need innovation. Even though you have a lot of great product, but you still need innovation. You don't just, oh, digital marketing, I can sell anything. No, you still need a product which can give some value to your customer. Very important. Okay? This coverage is particularly true in a digital landscape where word of mouth can spread to the four corners of the earth in the blink of an eye. If you sell the very poor product, it can destroy you within a minute. Okay, within a minute. I will give you a very great example. Okay, I think I can give you one tool. How many of you use this tool? Google Trend. Oh, sorry. Google Trend. If you want to know Google Trend, which is very trend in Malaysia, I think Niloufar. Niloufar. Okay, you just click Niloufar and look at the trend. How many people are searching for her? You see, Malaysia, I think past day. You see, people are looking for her. There are so many searches. All over the Malaysia, people search about her. All over the Malaysia, people are searching for her. Most famous is Negeri Sembilan. Why? Because this is one of, no, I'm not telling about, you know, this is just a popularity. Okay? For, okay? Niloufar is one of the digital marketers. She always, she's an influencer. Social media or social marketing, social media influencer. Okay? You see? Negeri Sembilan, people like to search about Niloufar. Okay, search about your name and you can compare. Okay, who is very famous in Malaysia? Okay, if you want to search about, let's say, Joe Biden, people, American president, okay, US president, who is dominating in Malaysia? You see, in Malaysia, people forget about, you know, Joe Biden. Okay, okay. Look for the Niloufar. This is one of the tools you can use. When you want to promote your product, search. See the keyword, whether people are looking for your product or not. Don't simply put any keyword. Okay? Let's say I remove Niloufar and I change to any other person. You can put the product name, whatever is it. Okay? Let's say I put, who is another? Okay? Okay, let's say I put Niloufar again. Okay, in Malaysia, Niloufar is very famous. Okay, but if I choose global, of course, Joe Biden. Okay, you see, that's the thing. Even you can type, your name, whether people are looking for your product or not. Let's say you want to put anything in your product. Okay, let's say you use Mahal. Okay, Tamahal. Okay. Murah. Okay. Which term is the correct term you should use in your marketing when you write a content? You see, people don't use product saya Tamahal. Belilah product saya. Wrong. Okay, wrong. You have to put murah. Produk saya ni agak murah. Okay. Ataupun letak berbaloi, contohnya. So you have to compare the keyword. The keyword is the essence. Okay, keyword is the essence of the marketing. That is called content writing, copywriting. You should be a good storyteller. Digital marketing is a story. How you narrate the story, how you tell the people. Okay. Sometimes even I could not even, do not know how to write. the right good story. To write a good story doesn't mean you need a, you know, Moed Band 6, ILTS 9. No. You need a perfect word to write a story. Oh, Alif Shukri. Oh, Alif Shukri. Okay, never mind. I just fulfill the demand of the audience. Is it the correct name? Is it the right? I don't know. You want Ilofa? Okay. This is only for the class purpose. Eh? Don't viral. Okay. Talk. Okay. Because internet world move based on the what are the trends. So now trend is Ilofa. Okay. That's the thing. Okay. Worldwide. Okay. We go to Malaysia. Is there anyone Afghanistan look for our people? No one. Definitely. They no data. Okay. No data. What about Indonesia? So you can see. So famous. Okay, very famous. Okay, so you can see how rich you are in terms of contents. Okay. Oh, so many requests. Okay, we don't have enough time, sufficient time. I've given very limited time to cover everything. Okay, sorry, Izzati. Okay. Okay, good. Great. The another wrong assumption is you are not overly technical. Okay. As I mentioned to you earlier, you are not required to be a highly technical person in order to run your business. Okay, you don't need to be highly technical. It means digital marketing can be as technical as you want to make it. If you want to learn how a web server works or how to write in PHP code programming, feel free. However, to succeed in the marketing field, you need to understand marketing, not coding. Okay, that's the thing. That's the keyword, marketing. Where you can learn this marketing? From university. Okay, everywhere you can learn, but as long as you are a student, you have a lot of opportunity. You learn from, you know, university. We have a lot of platform in university. Okay, SEDI, SBN, you know, we have a SIMPA and so many programs run. Okay, run by these institutions. In the university, there are a lot of marketing program, you know, business program, entrepreneurship programs, even how to build, you know, your platform, website, and so on. You can utilize, you can optimize, okay, everything. So you don't need any technical, you know, skills specifically. Do I need to take IT on it? Remove this, you know, myth, okay? And you are willing to implement and adjust. Okay, this is the thing that I quote earlier. You have to implement and adjust. Adjust means you have to run according to the digital evolution. Okay, digital evolution. You are very famous in TikTok. Suddenly new system come up. And this is a trend right now. Maybe the new application. So you have to move to that application to catch, you know, to capture the customer. That's the thing. Okay, once upon a time in Malaysia, lelong.com is very famous. You have no choice. If you want to buy online, go to lelong.com. Now, people close one eye and keep on blinking, you know, whether I want to buy from this website or not. Now, people move to other platforms such as Shopee, Lazada, Carousel, you know, even they go to Amazon.com, you know, eBay, and so on. Okay. So you have to remove all the wrong assumptions. Okay, you don't need to be a technical person. Then you don't be so proud of you. I'm a good marketer, world-class marketer. But you can sell a poor thing for a long run. Okay? Because digital landscape can kill you within a minute. People start to talk about your product, you know, start to write about your product very bad. Within a second, your business can doom. Okay, and you have to be adjustable person. and you have to implement and adjust accordingly. Those days, people are, advertising the product in print, television, and radio marketing. Now they move to digital marketing. You open YouTube, you can see, every five, when you want to watch 1 hour, cover story or anything, every 5-15 minutes, you will see one, advertisement, interject, or we call it interstitial advertisement. So that's the thing, digital marketing, okay? Okay, so now I can move to, I can tell you about the sub tools. These are the things. I think you never seen this one before this. In the world, there are three types of companies. Whether you want to be a white shark, you want to be a swordfish, or you want to be a piranha, you have to position yourself. Most of our technology companies, they use this concept. Whether you want to be a white shark, swordfish, or piranha, what are the difference? Okay. When you move to digital marketing, you will understand all of this. Okay. You see, Facebook, Google, Apple, Alibaba, Amazon, and these companies are so-called digital white shark. Okay? These companies are very few, not many Google, not many Amazon. Okay? Not so many companies are equal to Amazon, not so many companies to Alibaba. When you want to compare Alibaba to another company, there is no company to compare. Alibaba is Alibaba. Very famous, okay? Amazon, Facebook, okay? And these companies are wide, diverse product portfolio. The name is Google, search engine, but their product is, oh my God. Google is not a company, yeah? Google is a brand and also a company, okay? By its name, Google. But the original company name is Alphabet. A-L-P-H-A-B-E-T, Alphabet. Parent company, and under that is a Google. Okay, so you see, then Alphabet, they have a YouTube and so on. Okay, white shark. These companies, whether you hit this company or whether you close with this company, you will be soup. Okay, finished within a second. You don't disturb these companies, including Microsoft. Okay, Microsoft and so on. Okay, Swordfish. Swordfish is a company which can kill other company within a second, even though this company is very small and very fast growing company. Overnight become a famous, or within a month become famous, like a Netflix. Netflix killed the film industry, not film industry, it means kill the haters. Because now people want everything personalized. They don't want to go to the, theater. What they do, they set their own own theater, and they buy Netflix, they access to Netflix, and they watch movie at home. And these companies are killing. And also Uber killed the taxi drivers, Airbnb killed the hotel. These are called swordfish. Okay, very fast, but if you near to this company, it will hit you immediately. Digital marketing, okay, because of digital marketing. Few companies, but big industry shaping players. Okay? They are vertical specific product. It means they don't sell anything, They just specifically sell something. Okay? And these are very famous one, digital piranhas. Okay? These companies are very small company, but very powerful. Maybe the staff only 100 or 1,000 people only, very small company. Okay, compared to the big companies like Google, few thousands people. But this company only 500 people. But in terms of profit, in terms of aggressiveness, in terms of growth, very fast. Piranhas. And you cannot get closer, They will poop, poop, poop. They will eat just like that. Okay? You want to be a whale. Okay, also, Dr. Noria. Whale is moving very slow, not very fast. That's why they don't put whales here. Okay? Whales are very very protective, but don't move very fast. This one very move fast. Okay. Thank you, Dr. Naria. Okay, good, great. You see, when you go to digital marketing, okay, I will touch digital tools, okay, because it's not easy to touch everything today. Okay, when you go to the digital marketing, you have to touch this one, the purpose. You must know your goals in digital marketing. Let's say you are selling a cake. Okay, students are like to sell, you know, cakes. What are the things that you want to sell? Normally, what I see is cakes. Sometimes, you know, tudung. What else? Cosmetics. How about the unicorn company? I don't have idea, doctor. Unicorn company. Okay. What are the products are very famous? Okay, cosmetics. Okay, and I think based on my experience in UUM, mostly cosmetic, tudung, what else? Food in terms of like a cake, you know, the nasi lemak and so on. You know, nothing wrong, but the competitiveness is, I mean, very high. Okay, yeah. Anyway, when you go to digital marketing, these are the perfect goals. You have to go to this one. First is improve customer service, because you can deal with the customer at any point of time. 24 hours, you can respond to your customer. Early morning, 12:45, early morning, 1 o'clock morning. Okay? Like my friend, you know, today, not yesterday. Today, 1 o'clock morning, I prepared a slide. Okay? I just prepared this slide yesterday, 10 o'clock. After my 10:30, I prepared this slide. Okay? 10:30 after my session with the LinkedIn. Okay, I attended one training at 9 o'clock yesterday. Okay, 9 o'clock. Then I prepare and around 1 o'clock, I think I prepare, finish around 12 o'clock, and 1 o'clock I send this one to my friend, and my friend immediately respond. Thank you, Madi. I was shocked, you know. You see, power of digital marketing. Immediately I can respond. Immediately I can get the information. Okay, that's improved customer service. And you increase your brand awareness. People know about your brand. Actually, Nilofa, if let's say Nilofa started a business 20 years back, I think it's very difficult to know Nilofa, because there is no digital marketing at that time. But Nilofa is very famous because of digital marketing, not because of Nilofa. Okay, she knows how to put herself in the digital. And she keep on informing a lot of things and a lot of stories about her. Okay, you have to look at the Nilofa in the point of, you know, business. Don't look at it in other ways. Okay, I'm trying to say, okay, business perspective. And lead generation, you have to go deeper. Whether you want to go for the sales generation or lead generation. Lead generation means you have to tell your customer, you don't force your customer to buy. Okay, that is lead generation. And informing your customer. Okay, informing your customer existence of the product and generate traffic. Okay, when people search about your product should be boom, appear. And also direct customer engagement in the Facebook, Twitter, or Instagram, TikTok, and so on. And also you can have a direct customer engagement through WhatsApp business. Not WhatsApp personal, WhatsApp business. Okay. Wait, just 1 second. 2 seconds. Okay. Good. Cheers. Okay. This one. Okay. This is very theoretical things, but this is very important as well. So strengthen digital marketing. When you want to think about digital marketing, okay, forget about tools. I'm talking about effort. Remember, I put two words, right tools and right effort. Now I'm talking about right effort. Later I will move to right tools, whether I don't know whether I have enough time or not, but I will expose to you some tools that you can explore. So two things, right effort and right tools. One missing, one available, you gone. Okay, strengthen the digital marketing platform. Okay, first understand your customer. Do not sell your product to the customer that you did not or you should not inform. Don't tell about the cake to the people who are almost 65 years old. Definitely they ignore your advertisement. 65 years already they have, you know, kecil manis. What we call it, diabetic, okay? Diabetic and so on. Do you think they will buy? Actually, you are not selling the product, you know, you are giving the poison. For them, cake is a poison. Okay? If you are selling a cake to the 65 years old, it's a poison. If they are diabetic person, patient, sorry. Okay? But when you sell cake to the youngsters, it's not a poison. It's a present, gift for them. Oh my God, wonderful cake. I want to eat. Even age of 40, you know, people stop eating cakes right now. Okay, I have a few friends. And they look at the cake, they will blink their eyes. The eyes telling to take it, but the mind telling don't take it. So they have a conflict of, you know, consuming. Okay, don't create a conflict of consumption. Okay, conflict of consumption. Don't create. If you create, you are losing customer. So that's why you have to understand your customer, who, where, when, and what. Then you create a brand awareness. Okay, brand awareness. So to create a brand awareness, you can use several tools. And you can target your market. In the Facebook, Instagram, you can target your market because you can do the Facebook ad. I think social media, Dr. Munira will cover in series 2. Okay? What are the tools you can use in order to do some segmentation and relevant offer by using the social market? Okay, my good friend, okay, Dr. Munira will cover in second series. Okay, stay tuned. Maybe they can post after the session, okay, about that program. Okay, and last one, interactivity. Okay, what is interactivity? Very simple. When you fall in love, you have to talk to your girlfriend or boyfriend. Otherwise, they won't. You cannot maintain your relationship. Put it this way, yeah? Just put simple way. That is interactivity. You have to interact, okay, with your customer. If you sell the product but you don't interact, you can't expect the repurchasing. Digital marketing, they can kill you within 1 second. Don't buy this product. Lousy product. They don't interact with you. They don't communicate. Okay? That is called increased brand advocacy, acceptance. And also expand delivery. You communicate with them, interactivity. Okay? Okay, that's the thing. Okay, these are the tools you can use. Wonderful. You can use, okay, let's say affiliate marketing. Okay, maybe I can tell this one. Affiliate marketing, it's not, you know, selling a product or selling an item, you know. Affiliate means you are not required to sell anything. You just affiliate with someone. You try to be an ambassador or you try to be an affiliator to sell the product. Okay, then you will be paid commission. And another one is a display advertising. Okay, display advertising. Affiliate marketing, either you can join affiliate or you create an affiliate. Okay, another one is a drop shipping, almost similar but quite different. Okay, display advertising is very famous. You go to the website, you go to the apps, you can see the advertising. That is one of the tool promote your product. And content writing, you can use in social media. You just, you know, write the content. Search engine optimization, this is a very famous one. When you search product in Google, something will pop up like this. Okay, sorry, yeah, two times repeated, okay? It's supposed to be search engine marketing, not optimization, okay? If you go to Google, just, okay, click tudung, huh? Okay, just click tudung bawah, okay? Something will come out like this. Okay. Let's say you want to go for the printer, computer. Let's say computer. This is search engine optimization. Okay. Computer, definitely. Okay. Desktop. Okay. You see, When you want to buy computer desktop, you see, this is called Google Ads. This is a paid advertisement. They pay to the Google to make sure their website pop up in the first rank. This is, we call it SRP, search result page. Okay, this is another training, Google Ads. Okay, and you see, these people pay, but these people never pay, but still number one because of their website also and the keywords. This is called search engine optimization. Okay, that's the thing. Okay, and also, you know, mobile marketing. You can use mobile marketing, especially Instagram. Instagram is mobile marketing. TikTok is mobile marketing. And also social media marketing, Facebook, Instagram, and so on. Okay. And search engine marketing, or we call it social media optimization. Social media optimization is, I missed one point, social media. When you go to Facebook, okay. When you go to Facebook, these are the things will pop up in front of you. You go to Facebook, you just type, okay? Let's say you want to type Tudung Bawal. Let's say I use the only one term, Tudung Bawal. So the pages will come up and the most popular one will come up, okay? And it will come up like this. You see? Like this. Okay? Post people and. And in Facebook, you can market your product in by using two different ways. One is using a marketplace or use your brand page, or we call it business page. This one in the next series, you can get deep knowledge. Okay. I just introduced the tools. And the last one is email marketing. Okay. These are the steps you are using in Facebook. Okay, business page, create a post, like marketing, boost post. Boost post you have to pay, and also the advertisement, okay, Facebook ads. Okay, and you have to monitor conversion rate, whether it's really rich or not. And you have to follow up the sales. Okay, I don't have enough time. What is the difference between marketplace and Facebook page? Not Facebook page, Facebook business page. Okay, marketplace, you don't need to open a store to sell your product. You directly promote your product. Click marketplace and you upload your item. You place the price and every information directly sell. You are not required to create a business page. But business page, you have to create a business page. You have to create a banner. You have to create an advertisement for it. That's a different. Okay. Okay, Fadila. I'm answering your question. Okay, good. So it's almost end of the session. It's gone. Okay, Instagram, I just want to show to you the another one. And WhatsApp business, this is the thing. Okay. And YouTube. Okay, I think I can take opportunity to, Dr. Jauria and Dr. Azrin, please give me do some personal branding to myself. Okay. This is my YouTube. I have a YouTube channel. You can create your YouTube channel to promote yourself. This is my YouTube channel. I always upload about the computer and some other systems. Okay. Website building and so on. Okay. So I have there are so many videos. Okay. You can go to my channel. Okay. For example, like this. And when you watch, please do subscribe. So I would like to share the channel, one of the video. From that video, you can go to multiple videos from my channel. Okay. So this is the thing. Go ahead. I share in the chat box. You can like my page as well. This is my YouTube channel. Okay. I always share with my students and also for the outsiders. Okay, please allow me to share as well. Okay, YouTube channel is very easy to create. Nowadays, with a lot of tools, you can create it. Okay, one other thing. And YouTube channel is more to the influencing people. Okay. And you can share their videos. Okay. Please do subscribe. Okay. And enjoy the videos in my channel. Okay. And if you have no idea, don't know how to use any tool, I don't have idea of the Facebook. Okay. What you can do, you can directly sell your product in marketplace like Shopee, Lazada, and any other platform. Okay, you can sell that. You can create a shop in the Shopee seller center. You can sell product from the Shopee. Okay. If you come to my class, definitely you have to sell the product in the Shopee. Okay. One of the assignment. Okay. Join my class if you want to learn about Shopee. Okay, great. And apart from that, these are the some advertising things, tools you can use. No worries, I will share the slide. After that, you know, after the session, you can get it. Okay. Okay, this is the last slide that I want to share with you. Okay. Okay, let me answer one question before I wrap up. Okay. Oh, I just tell about this one. These are the some books I like to read to get some motivation. I have most of the books, except this book I didn't. Tap Dancing, this book. But I have a soft copy, if I'm mistaken. The rest of the books I bought. Okay. So you can read these books to get some understanding about the world of the business, like Alibaba. This is from Wan Nong, okay, one of my friend. Okay. I did learn from him earlier, you know, in 2015-16 about the digital marketing. Okay. And some other books you can read. Okay. And Irfan Khairi is one of the top internet figure in Malaysia. You just search about him. Irfan Khairi. Okay. And this guy is the most, you know, famous one. Muhammad Yunus. I like him because he's very famous for the social entrepreneurship. Okay. Great. That's it from my side. Just one simple advice before I answer the question. You have no product. You don't want to personalize yourself for the branding. You don't want to do any personal branding. Okay, but I want to make money. Can I make money without product? Can I make money without doing personal branding? Can I make money without service? You still can make money. You still can make money. How is it? Okay, very soon you will learn about this one. You go to the eReziki. This is under MDEC program. You go and register under eReziki and learn eReziki. eReziki is a freelancing program. You can be a digital person or you can do some, you know, content writing and you can earn money. The further info about eReziki will come to all of you very soon. Okay? But for time being, you go and learn about this one, eReziki. Okay, R-E-Z-E-K-I. Okay, eReziki. Okay, let me answer one question. Okay, I have to move very fast. Huh? Yeah, eReziki. Thank you. In your opinion, what are the tips for one who is interested in opening online business? Okay, nowadays, if you want to open online business, you have to choose the right tool first. For the first time, you don't sell your product in your own website. Okay, first you create a brand awareness first. It means you use the Facebook, you use your okay, you use your any platform, Facebook or whatever platform, to sell your product. Then slowly you move to Shopee, Lazada, Amazon when you want to go for that global e-commerce. Shopee is a local, not a very global. If you want to go to a global, go to Amazon. So start small, but big dream. Don't small dream, big business. Wrong. Okay? And use the right tool and right effort. Okay? Usaha sendiri as well as can be used, cursor. Usaha sendiri mean what, Atif? Usaha sendiri, Atif.
Afif, what do you mean by the question? Usaha sendiri as well?
Usaha sendiri is effort.
Uh-huh. Can be used, cursor.
Yes, of course. Usha simply mean your knowledge, your ability, and experience. These three things will promise the passion. If you don't have these three, you don't have a definitely you can't move to your passion. It won't create a passion. Okay? Okay. Why Amazon not as famous as Shopee and Lazada in Malaysia? Okay. Very simple. Amazon is very famous. In fact, you know, Amazon, Jeff Bezos is the richest man in the earth. Sorry, on the earth. Okay? But not very famous in Malaysia. Because, very simple, most of the sellers are from outside of the Malaysia. Okay? Outside of the Malaysia. And it costs some other things, you know, like a shipping price and so on. And Amazon is very famous in Europe, US, India, very famous. That's why, you know, if you go to India, no Shopee, no Lazada. They don't think about that one. They only talk about Amazon.in.India. Okay? Because a big country. And Amazon, Malaysia is not a big business for Amazon. Amazon go for their largest business scales. Okay? I mean, Usaha Sendiri, place where people started learn about business from nothing to something. Oh, yes, sure. I mean, Usaha Sendiri is a place where people started learn about business from nothing to something. Sure. Definitely. Okay, you have to start from zero. No one start from, you know. Yeah, same like Irezeki. Okay. Okay. That's the thing. Thank you very much. Oh my God, we have a question.
Another last question, ataupun ada any other question from the floor?
Any other questions?
Last question from Ng Gek Peng. Doctor, how do we reach out to the new customers other than using Facebook or IG paid advertisement?
Okay, how do we reach out to new customers other than using FB and IG paid ads? Okay, what you can do is, okay, this is a very simple idea. Okay, you don't want to use paid ads, no problem. Okay, in FB you still have, you know, some advertisement or some you know what we call it, you know, advertisement, you don't need to pay, you still can use FB. But if let's say you want to reach more customer, try to do like a TikTok, YouTube and live session. When you do the FB live session, okay, FB live session, you can reach more customer and you promote to everyone, people watch, and that's the thing we call it lead sales, lead generation. You reach more customers, but they are not customer at the first time. They will be your audience and you have to convince them through your FB live or IG stories or IG live or whatever, IG TV, okay? Then in the long run, you will convert them as your audience without you pay any advertisement fees. Okay, you still can use. Okay, apart from FBIG, you can use other tools. Okay, like a LinkedIn and so on. LinkedIn is a professional network. Okay, for the personal branding, the perfect one is a LinkedIn. Okay, you can get a lot of things from the LinkedIn. Okay, this is more to the lecturers. Okay, lecturers are not selling any product. Maybe they want to sell, you know, their knowledge. They want to advertise themselves. They can use their LinkedIn. This is the thing. Okay. You can put in your LinkedIn. This is a personal branding. I have a message. You see. Okay. You see, our friend, Abdul Halim. Okay. Then you can create a good. Okay. Today, I have a lot of views today. Then you can put everything over here about yourself. Okay. And you can be connected. This is one of the ways to promote yourself, to build your personal brand. Okay, that's it. Thank you very much for your passion with the, you know, my loud voice. Okay, thank you, Dr. Azrin.
Audience. Thank you very much, okay, Dr. Mathivanan, okay, for your very input for this first session. And then remember, okay, the first thing that have been taught about personal branding, okay? So we will start with our name, okay, our product and our service, and of course, okay, if you do have a own company. And another keyword, remember, you should have the right tools and the right effort, or right effort with the right tools, right? And about the white sharks, okay, the swordfish and piranhas, and another one additional by Dr. Nora is on the whale, all right? So all this is among the key term, okay, important that we can go on with the digital marketing. So we further that, okay, thank you very much again to Dr. Mati Banan, and inshallah we'll see again on a second session with Dr. Munira. Okay?